Meet Joe Kirschvink, geobiologist at Caltech. He's quite an iconoclast. He is one of the first people to come up with the idea of the snowball Earth hypothesis in this 1992 paper, in which he says there's no other way to explain the data other than to say that there were glaciations at the equator at several times in the ancient past, maybe 600, 700 million years ago. He's also somebody who still thinks that the ALH84001, it's a meteorite from Mars, might contain evidence that life existed on Mars based on the magnetite crystals. And sometimes he likes to explore his own brain looking for magnetic sensitivity. That's one of his things he does. And also he's written a new book, A New History of Life, The Radical New Discoveries About the Origins and Evolution of Life on Earth, with Peter Ward. And Peter Ward is known for one of the founders of the Medea hypothesis. Here's Medea, here's Gaia. Gaia says, oh, life takes care of itself, makes the Earth good for other life forms. And Medea says, no, no, life is trying to kill itself. It's really bad. Anyway, I sat down with him in Tokyo, and we talked about the question, are we alone? What is your name?
Joe Kirschvink.
All right, and are you an Earth scientist, an astronomer?
I'm not sure. Okay. I'm something about between a geophysical neurobiologist.
Are we alone in the universe?
When I wake up in the morning, I'm not alone. But the question I assume you mean, is Earth life alone in the universe?
That's the one version of it, yes.
I sort of doubt it. Too many planets out there, too many things orbiting other stars, too many other places. However, I am a fan of something called the Medea hypothesis that basically says life couldn't give a damn about what it does on a planet. We see examples of this in Earth history. Snowball Earth events, the biggest one that we know of is probably McEnany. Think it was triggered directly by the evolution of oxygenic photosynthesis. Damn near killed the planet. If we'd been just a little bit further from the sun, that snowball would have allowed carbon dioxide to freeze out at the pole.
Well, do you think that once life evolves, that it evolves in a direction of human-like intelligence and technology?
No.
What do you think?
They can't give, life would not know any end game. We're looking back at it because we got here. Mm-hmm. I can see billions of planets out there, maybe with stromatolites. And they're very happy stromatolites. They're sitting there doing their thing. They know nothing else.
So you think there are more planets with stromatolites than planets with telescopes?
Absolutely.
Is the question, are we alone, an important one?
Of course it's important. If it turns out we're not alone, just think about the ramifications. If we're not alone and we can understand it, particularly, what does it take to avoid catastrophe, to avoid becoming the end product of a Medean biosphere? That's extremely important.
If I gave you $100 billion with the caveat you have to spend it to try to answer the question, are we alone, what would you spend it on?
Influencing the next election.
What, explain the chain of reasoning there.
Well, we have evolved to the point where we might prevent the next Medean tragedy or cause it.
Right.
And if we want to at least keep the number of planets with animal life at a minimum of one, we might want to invest those resources that way.
Okay, so the idea is we should stay alive, invested in staying alive.
Exactly.
As the number one prerequisite for finding extraterrestrials in the future.
But it's not going to be done if we die.